Well, hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. Just to give you guys some more information about this Kennett Middle School thing, like I said, you know, I don't make blatant, baseless accusations, and the chatter around town is that Kennett Middle School fails, and, you know, it's just treating parents horribly, and children aren't getting educated unless they fit inside a stereotypical box. With me now is a young girl that I really respect. Her name is Denae. And Denae, how old are you again?
15.
And you did try to go to Kennett Middle School. You did go there for a short time. When was that?
7th and 8th grade.
Okay, 7th and 8th grade, and was that a year?
2 years ago.
2 years ago. And what happened? What was your experience there?
It was not the best. It was a pain in the butt for both me and my mother.
Okay, and did you have trouble with learning? Was that it? Did you have any special programs you had to attend?
I had no special programs I had to attend.
No special programs?
No.
Just personality conflicts at school, or were they treating you unjustly?
Unjustly.
Now, can you give me any examples?
Well, I believe that after school, when you were waiting for the bus, you should be allowed to wear hats and hoods. You are not in the classroom. And the teachers will yell at you for no reason, and you'll get written up on the bus for being wrongly accused.
And the bus, so a lot of the trouble you had stemmed from the bus environment? Is that right?
Yes.
Now, you don't ride the same bus that Joseph does, but you know a lot of the kids on there? And you interacted with them, and you have for several years. If I were to ask them, what would they say the environment on that bus is like, or most buses?
Chaotic.
Chaotic, right. Okay, and that's been a couple of years now, at least, as far as you know of. So, okay, teachers are yelling at you, but were you able to finish your time there?
No.
You weren't. What did you do?
I was homeschooled the end of 7th grade and 8th grade.
The end of 7th and 8th grade. You had to homeschool. Your mom had to homeschool. I'm sure she wasn't happy about that.
Nah.
I mean, she had no choice because she needs to educate her daughter, so kudos to her, homeschooling. But you're a responsible girl, so you made it happen. You met your grades and did what you needed to do, right? You weren't held back.
Nope.
But you had to do it on your own.
Yeah.
Did you feel there was enough support for what you needed at Kennett Middle School?
No.
I mean, pretty obvious not. I don't want to speak for you, but pretty obviously not if you had to, 2 years in a row, had to finish at home. If you had to guess how many kids are in that situation where they either have to finish at home, they get expelled on a regular basis, kicked off buses on a regular basis, just a rough number, how many kids do you think are not being educated for these type of reasons at Kennett Middle School?
I have to say most.
Most?
Yes.
Most of the kids your age?
Yeah.
Right. Well, I mean, I guess it's probably not most, but I do think that if there are any issues outside of the box, if you're not in the clique, so to speak,
yeah. You're
probably going to have a hard time there. You know, it was the same when I went there, but it's much worse now. And I went there in the 80s, so that's a long time ago. Okay, Denae, thank you. I know it's tough, but you did an awesome job, and I appreciate it. And to the parents, you know, if you're in the Conway area and you've been mistreated by the school, I'd like to hear from you, even if you don't feel like being on camera. At least shoot me an email, give me a phone call, give me some way to validate. I've heard the stories, folks. I know, you know, some of you guys, and you've really been mistreated, and your kids are suffering, and not everybody can stand up and speak, but I can, and I'm willing, and so get a hold of me. Much love, many thanks. Denae, thank you, and we'll see all you YouTubers and human beings later on.